सुन पाए स्टूडियो ज्वाइनिंग बिकॉज यू आर अबाउट टू फिनिश योर कोर्स सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स यू शुड नो एंड प्रिपेयर योर सेल्फ एंड बिफोर लाइक वन मोर थिंग इज विच इज वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट वेन एवर लाइक डोंट रश योर सेल्फ वेन एवर यू प्लानिंग टू फर्स्ट अपडेट योर पोर्टफोलियो polish your things like make sure it's really great quality like which is very 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 important otherwise it will like be problematic for you in future like getting a job because you can see like this student like she her like she is very dedicated very hard working and everything but that is not reflecting in her portfolio so she have applied in so many companies But still, she haven't got one single reply. Reason? What that rubbish of a resume? Nobody will read that much of a like thing. Like so, nobody will read that, and the kind of portfolio you send, people will consider. Like, suppose I am you send me a file. Like suppose I am going to judge you. You going to say you have sent me something for a job, and job is something you are getting paid for it. That is something you have to keep in your mind. So people won't pay you just like that. You need to be unique, need to be very good whatever you do. Then only they will hire you and pay you money for that. So what you have to do is you have to like when you first thing first, revisit your this thing. Sorry, all your portfolio pieces. Make sure. Create a very good quality portfolio. Try to make it unique, as much unique as possible, and post-process it. And like maybe it's a small prop, it's a big prop. Doesn't matter as long as the quality is amazing. Maybe it's just a small box. I'll show you. I guess I have bunker. So this guy, so like this guy, like he's a very dedicated. I know him personally. So a problem with this guy is he doesn't know where to stop, and where to stop. And you can see he just created this lighter, normal Indian typical 10-20 rupees by lighter. You can see he have added this fingerprints and the small things. He created model. And everything. It's a quite a decent polygon model. This is out of his entire portfolio. This one is the best. I hired him basically. Like that time I was like in that company. I was working as a supervisor. So I hired him. So like what impressed me. Like rest I'll show you. So he changed. Like there were a few things which are like really bad. So now he updated it. Like this is okay. This is not great. This kind of stuff anyone can do. You can see like render. There is no shadow. There is no highlight. There is nothing. So this doesn't look nice. And like all low poly, all angles. Okay, I can see everything. That's fine. But like make sure it should be. You can see it's a straight line. Cut. It should not be like this. Whenever you have something like this. Add a cut, make it a little bit more rounded. There's no lie, this renders are rubbish, very bad. Low poly is good, his low poly is pretty good. Low poly is good, everything is good. Only thing, render is very poor. So whenever you submit something like this, people, like suppose they have options, they will never select you. So make sure, because I know this guy personally, so I know he, what kind of skill he have. So that's what I'm saying. I know he's a good artist, but thing is, portfolio, it's bad. Then, this is like nice, but this is nice. Like simple, you can see it's just a pillar. It's just a pillar, nothing else, but it should look nice. What is it? This is some pillar. So like out of this entire thing, only this thing is nice. So So I guess you understood what I'm trying to explain here. It's not about the scale of your level, your environment or your model or all those things. It's about the quality. Like attention to detail, the how much detail. You can see there's a small fine scratches. You can see this sticker. The edges are a little bit toed off and the crooked and all those things. It's not that sharp. There's a slight color variation also. So those attention to detail matter. Those small things matters. Rest everything doesn't matter. The quality of your whatever you're delivering, that matters. So it's all about that. It can be a small, tiny crop. Doesn't matter. The attention to detail, the quality of output, that's what matters. So that is something you need to understand and deliver it. So cover letter. Cover letter is something whenever you apply to any company, you need to research about that company. And cover letter is basically, in cover letter, you write what you know about the company and why you are applying to that company. What is the reason? Like you like their kind of, what kind of work they have, what kind of job perks they have, or what kind of employee-employer relationship they have, or policies they have, or benefits, or job or well-paid salary, or whatever. You need to research about that. There's a site, there's an app or site is there, Glassdoor. Go and check whichever company you're applying. Go and check that company's review and feedback. Check that Glassdoor. I believe you guys know already. Like this particular generation, I know they're very smart. So research about that and state those things. First of all, I am pursuing bachelor. All these things are not required. That is something you have already mentioned in your mail. Or it's part of your resume already. So no, there's no point mentioning same thing again and again and in same portfolio link again and again. That's a bit irritating. You're not supposed to do it. You see, portfolio link here, portfolio link here, portfolio link here. That's stupid. You're not supposed to do it. Just mention your portfolio link either in your mail. In mail you can mention, and plus in resume you can mention. That's fine. You can see here also you have a link. Here also you have link. That's just stupid. One link here just to quick access, and one link here. If you want, just instead of going to your resume, they can click it and go to your. That's perfectly fine. And make sure your resume is an online public domain resume or portfolio. It should not be some website somewhere, only people who know it, they can go. It should be a public domain, like ArtStation, maybe LinkedIn, maybe ZBrush Central, CG Society, those sites. So or maybe Behance. So those sites you're supposed to use, it should be on public on a public domain. And then research about the company and state your things why you applying to that company. Suppose I am applying to Rockstar. So I'll mention there hi, sir, madam, whatever it is. So I'm this, and I came across this opportunity. And that's your mail. So why are you applying here? Why are you applying? Because the kind of work they do, Rockstar doing, or kind of games they have delivered in past, research, go and check the website and check what kind of clients they serve, what kind of games they have delivered, read those names, state those names, I like the work in this XYZ game, XYZ movie or commercial or something, and I like this particular thing, so I really like to work for you. Because I believe I have this kind of skill set that can be added to your company, and I can deliver something extra and all those things. So make it very specific to that company. That is your cover letter. Very, very, very specific to that company. And your resume is very clean, crisp, to the point. Don't put my date of birth, my hobbies, like I have seen people submit those things by hobbies, then people mention like objective is fine. Then they suddenly mention my strong points, like strong points and all those things. Like suppose you say, I have strong leadership quality, but you need to give them something to support that. I have good leadership quality. Then in below achievements, suppose you have done something in leadership, like suppose some you conducted something or you was were part of some team or something, like you did something and you were the leader of that. So you achieved that and you like proved yourself as a leader. So you have to give a like relatable context there. Like if you have like, okay, you are a team player and team, you are a team leadership quality team player or like you're dependable, how? Right? I can state anything, right? I can write anything. Like, but what if I am not a team player? So you have to give something. Okay, I was in like in college. There was this this project we did in a group, and I was the team leader for that, and we have delivered this. And suppose you have that work in your portfolio, showcase that this particular work I have created with that this team or whatever it is. So like that. So you need to give them a relative, like all those with reference, like whatever you are stating. So you have to say and do all this thing properly, polish your stuff. And there's like one more deal. This is, I guess you guys know, Yash, like from 192. Yash and Darshan. So, like, okay, and now I'll show you, and I'll the same thing, like what to do, what not to do. This is like he added this in his portfolio. That's a like really stupid thing to do. Reason, this is a class task, initial stage class task to understand the software. Yes, you can definitely add it. You can definitely like add to portfolio, but you have to polish it then. Like once you started, like this is like in the first module, when you started, and then when you end your module, end your entire course, the quality of skill and everything will change. So according to that, you have to revisit, modify everything, remaster this thing again. You can see it's really low poly. I can see cut. That's not acceptable. It's floating. You can see there's a shadow. It's floating in air. That's again like nonsense. Shape is not all good. So you can definitely use it, but make sure it's really have that what it takes, like that quality. Like we just checked all those like things, so that quality should be there. This is really bad. Okay, like it's lighting shadow and looks fine, but like shadow is obviously bad, like base shadow. Either you delete the base, don't keep it, don't keep this thing, or keep it in proper at proper place, and you have a nice clean shadow. So you have to keep very, because whenever you submit anything for any employer and any employer, he will judge you, right? So they will nitpick everything. Why is this floating? It is, you don't have a common sense, or you don't know you don't know how to present it, right? So like maybe it sounds really harsh the way I'm telling you all this thing, because you have just one module left. So all these things you need to understand and pay great attention, because these small minute, it won't change much. It won't change much if you place it properly on the ground and then render it. Nothing will change. Still, you will get rejected because of this thing. Reason, but at least you have to make it smooth, clean, add variation, dirt, weathering. This I can see. This fiber direction is correct. This is entirely wrong. If this wooden fiber like this, if this will break, it cannot be like this. That's like it's a like basic understanding. And this cannot be like this. These are fine. This is fine. This will work. But those things you need to keep in mind, because you have to be very thoughtful. Where, like, whatever you submitting, make sure it's like it's the best what you can do. So if you have like 1% of doubt, don't submit it. Don't do whatever it needs to be done to get rid of that doubt. So do your best, whatever you can do best. Whatever you can do best. If you're having any doubts, any confusion, reach out to the people. That's until now, unless you ask for help, nobody will help you. So, this is very practical. I'm telling you all this thing very practically. This is how professional life works. Because after, after this, your final module, you apply to companies and you join some company and start working. So, that time, all of you, me, everybody who's working, we all are competition to each other. We all are your colleagues, right? So you will be treated as colleagues. So you need to, unless you ask for help, nobody will come and help you. So reach out to people, ask help, and build your network. Networking is very important. Create a LinkedIn account if you don't have it already. So create a LinkedIn profile, reach out to people, connect to all whichever company you want to apply. Forget about this, I want to work in only Bangalore, I want to work in only Hyderabad or Mumbai or somewhere. Don't bother, because gaming industry is quite small in India. It's north, south, east, west, doesn't matter. Only research about the company and always start from the biggest company. Always start from the biggest company. Because smaller companies are already there. But biggest, if you start from a biggest company, your entire resume changes, your quality of work changes, your exposure changes. Once you have big name in your portfolio and in your resume, it becomes very easy for you to join any company or apply anywhere. So it becomes very easy. Then you have, see, you have this thing. This is not at all up to the mark. Like, he submitted this portfolio for review for applying jobs and all. So I clearly said, this is not good. This is not good. I guess you can see. Like, if this part still looks fine. This is not at all acceptable. What is this? Like, it's the mushy, smooth, soft thing. It cannot be like this. It has to be that hard. It's a metal. It should look like metal. It's not just about the shader. It's about the shape, about the kind of damage it have. So all those things are very important. And whenever you submit this one and this one, there are so many students from AID. These are like basic elementary classes, just for introduction classes. And almost everybody have this thing. Everybody worked on this. So what happens when you showcase this, people start, they tend to compare it. Like, okay, I have seen better than this. So reject them, right? So if you're submitting something which is already existing, already there, out there, like hundreds of it, this hammer, this thing is hundreds of this hammer is already there. Like, people have created and submitted all this thing. So it's like, please do not do it. Don't fall into this trap. Don't make sure your portfolio is a bit unique. And because don't fall into this comparison thing, because this will create problem for you. Because if there's something I can compare, there always will be, because there's always a better person out there, better artist out there, like in some manner or other. So make sure, avoid this comparison thing. Okay, you want like this, modify this. It's a hammer. Convert this into a mace or some other stuff, some other tool, or some other weapon, right? So you understand the technique. The entire idea is not like these things are for learning, not for portfolio. That is something to understand. These things are where only and only for learning the basics of that software, those tools, not to make a portfolio piece. This is not at all a portfolio piece. This is again, you can see, submitted the same thing, and this is very poor quality. So not acceptable. So even if you submit something like this, make sure it's great. It's not. Like this is overall, it's fine. Render is very poor. But this is not good. Like this is like with this, what kind of job you'll get? Tell me. Like some architectural visualization, all those things, all those companies. Yes, of course you can get those jobs, but they don't pay you well. Like, and you can see there's no consistency in render. There is no consistency in render. There you have nice strong shadows, gray background. So make sure all the backgrounds are same or similar, almost similar. Lighting setup, if you're using hard shadow and bright lights, make sure it's kind of similar until and unless you have some scene setup or some mood to it. So make sure it looks similar, because it should look, and you can see, like this one looks good, this leaves and all looks pretty nice, but this, I can clearly make out this leaf, all the leaves are same, repetitive, right? This is, there's a tiling, I can see this like lines. Fix those things. I can see a seam here clearly. Not acceptable. And what is this? I don't have any idea. Like, what kind of render is this? So you're getting my point. Like, what I'm trying to say is, it doesn't matter. And this is like old. What is this? So, like I asked him to create some few new new sets. So he'll do that. Focus on all these things. Whatever you have, you can modify them, make it look really great, and avoid comparison. And modify. You can modify it anytime, right? Suppose you have a cart. Like if you Google. There are 100,000 types of cards available. Use the same technique, use your learning, modify that card into some other card so that nobody can compare it, right? So make sure, modify it, make it your own, make it your, because your artwork should speak you, like it's representing you, right? It should say, like what kind of work you like, what kind of kind of work you want to do, what kind of things you like doing in past, all these things should say about you, yourself. So make sure, make it your own style, whatever you like, and always have a reference. Please, this is something I have seen a lot. People, I don't know, they just simply don't use references. Why? If there is something already there pre-existed, which is approved by the company, which is like really good quality, use it. Be a smart worker. Don't be a hard working is nice, but I don't know how to put it in unnecessary labor. Like in Hindi they call it gadha majuri. Gadha majuri is basically like being stupid and dumb and doing something and working really hard. So I guess you heard of that donkey wala story, like when he had this cotton and he sat in the water. There's some childhood story. Something is basically read from that story. So don't do it like that. Just for sake of it, don't do it. Be a smart worker. And if something is already existing, use those techniques, use those things. Like Quixel Bridge is already there. So you can, don't use the model. You can for populating the scene or just make it a bit more fuller and all. You can definitely use it, but main setup should be your own original, created, and you can use those textures, right? You can use those textures, modify them. You can change the color, change the pattern, change the design. You could definitely do it. So use those things, work smartly. work really smartly, modify things, and only thing that matters is quality. That's the only thing. Okay, I guess I gave too much of gyan today. So let's revisit your work, because we don't tomorrow we'll start this Maya, this thing, and like we have created as a tree, so we'll start with the leaves and all, and I'll show you the UV, and UV pay really good attention, because Maya UV are really initially you might feel a little bit intimidating, bit difficult, but it's very easy, very convenient, and it's way faster as compared to Max. It's a 10 times faster than Max. And just few click, you can unwrap everything, layout everything, and do, and Maya layer automatic layouting is amazing. I'll show you all those things. So pay very good attention, and come up with all kind of questions, all kind of doubts, or anything you have, get it cleared. It's maybe from your Max, maybe from your ZBrush or Substance, Unreal, any software, anything, or any clarity you need, please get it cleared. Because we are here to help. So because once you pass out, and we have new batches and new things, new stuff, so it becomes very difficult to go back and check, because with time, what happens, we all memory fades out, and we forget what kind of work I've done or all something. So except few works we remember always, but so that's why get it cleared. Build your network, LinkedIn account, and connect to all the companies you want to work, connect to those employees, the supervisors, artists, connect with them, try to chat or chat, and then discuss what kind of opportunity they have, or that what kind of work they do, discuss those things, and understand what kind of quality you have to for that. Suppose you want to join Ubisoft in Mumbai or Pune. To join Ubisoft, quality of work, you all know it's great. So what kind of opening they have, for what kind of tests they give, what kind of quality benchmark they ask for, ask those employees. The reason, suppose I know, of course I know a couple of people here and there, but problem is, if I recommend something, they will again going to judge, and if they don't like your work, they won't forward it. Just for courtesy, they will say, okay, I have forwarded it, but they won't forward it, because nobody wants to take a chance with their reputation, right? So until and unless they know you personally, they have seen your work, nobody wants to do that. Because reputation, because it's a small industry in India, and reputation is very important. So that's why build your network nicely, and talk to people, and get to know what kind of work they are doing, what are the things are happening there, and whenever they have an opening, and when we can apply, what are the criteria, what kind of quality benchmark, ask for those things. And suppose they show you something benchmark, go and do create that, achieve the same quality. That is very important, because in gaming it's all about quality, nothing to do, even if you're suppose your efficiency is little lower end, but still people you accept it, as long as your quality is very good. Okay, there is too much of gyan, and 12:00 I have another class, so I'll see you guys tomorrow, and we'll continue with the heart and tree. And we'll create some alphas and create some UVs and all. I'll show you those things. It's very simple. I'm showing you only the basic, very simple, straightforward steps. No, nothing complex. So do that. Practice it. At least you should know the basics of Maya. So that is very important. When you apply to any company, you can state, okay, I know Maya, I know Max. Both the software I know. I know I have proficiency in Max, and Maya I have in beginner level. That's fine. If you know the beginner level also, if that company they are working on Maya, they can definitely train you and modify this very easy. They can go forward, right? Hello, take care. I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. Thank you, sir.